Australia used to be known for its fierce individualism in defense of personal freedoms. Well, now, lockdowns, intense tracking of citizens have people claiming the country has turned into a police state. All this when fewer than 1,200 residents have died from COVID in a nation of 25 million. Dale Hurd has the story.
In a now viral tweet, an Australian posted what they said is a view of the world's largest prison from space, a map of Australia. Australia is still a democracy, but its COVID restrictions are severe. It's hard to enter or leave the country unless you're a politician or a celebrity. Citizens are tracked with apps and soon by facial recognition. In some states, you have to have your phone scanned before entering a church. And some have been arrested for simply posting on social media about protests against COVID restrictions. The rest of the world is starting to ask if Australia can still be called a free country. Australia's lockdown has been so draconian, it's brought comparisons on social media to how Australia began, as a prison colony. This pregnant Australian mother was handcuffed and hauled away by cops in front of her children for simply posting on Facebook about a lockdown protest. The charge was incitement.
What on earth? Excuse me, what on earth? Can you, like, report this on you?
What's this?
She's pregnant.
This leader of an anti-lockdown group, also arrested for incitement, has now been in jail for 3 weeks.
You're under arrest for incitement?
You guys been following me?
Police helicopters look for lockdown violators, like these folks trying to enjoy an evening on a rooftop. And the government has fired rubber bullets and tear gas at anti-lockdown protesters, including children. James Allen, Garrick Professor of Law at the University of Queensland, calls it heavy-handed despotism.
It's been appalling in Australia, and I say that as a big fan of Australia. I'm Canadian, you can tell from the accent. But it's come as a real shock to me how conservative friends are perfectly happy to go along with this.
Australia consists of 6 states and 2 territories, each with their own COVID restrictions. Under a new home quarantine plan for international travelers, if you don't send the government your photo and location when it sends you a text, the police will come to your door. Melbourne pastor Paul Furlong has been arrested 3 times and placed in solitary confinement for opening his church during the lockdowns.
The reason I did was for what I believe was a greater law, and that was to obey the word of God. And so I had to choose God's law over man's law.
This church in Sydney, shown before the lockdown, was raided and fined for holding what authorities called an illegal service and for not scanning people's phones before they entered. Some pastors are now concerned that the government could require a vaccine passport before entering a church. We asked Evan Mulholland at Australia's conservative think tank, the Institute of Public Affairs, if he still considers Australia a free country.
Well, it's a good question. It's a question a lot of people across the political spectrum have been asking. These things don't happen in a vacuum. They happen when the political and cultural elites slowly take away our freedoms and they become normalized.
Australians have also begun turning in one another to authorities, East German style. In this tweet, an Australian mother was desperate to find a way home with her son and needed to cross a state border, violating lockdown restrictions. She was turned in to police. With this kind of behavior, you might think many thousands of Australians have died from COVID, but the death toll is under 1,200 out of a nation of 25 million people, or 0.0047% of the population. Almost 3 times that many Australians die every week from normal causes. But one poll showed most Australians favor living without freedom, because they fear COVID more than any other Western nation.
The media has just scared people senseless. The average person thinks, if I catch this, I'm going to die.
There have been several large and sometimes violent demonstrations against the lockdowns and against planned vaccine passports, and hundreds have been arrested. The government says the death toll would have been much worse without lockdowns.
Look at these people.
And they're saying now that life can only return to normal when most of the country is vaccinated.
They describe giving back our freedoms as some sort of a treat. as some sort of a reward, something that can be given back to us and aren't our fundamental freedoms that were stolen from us in the first place.
The Australian journalist Clive James once said, "The problem with Australians is not that so many of them are descended from convicts, but that so many are descended from prison officers." It's a quote that's being talked about a lot these days. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Now, don't